Hello guys, welcome back to another video. Today we are reacting to Dominic Fike DFAM B-sides. So yeah, I guess it's just some songs that did not make the album. So yeah, I just thought we'd take a listen. I really enjoyed Dominic Fike's music, you know. I pretty much enjoyed his whole EP and the stuff he did on Arizona Baby with Kevin Abstract. And yeah, I just thought we'd check this out real quick. I don't think there'll be too much to comment on, but yeah, let's just see. You know, obviously the mix isn't really good since these are just B-sides, but I think the core concept of the song is pretty cool, you know? Like the slightly grungy guitar in the beginning, you know? Sounds like some early 2000s pop rock song. I love this, man. That sounds really good. I think this should have made the album. But yeah, it's pretty cool. I love when artists release B-sides, you know. It's sort of interesting to see how similar they sound to what actually went on the album or mixtape. So yeah, this is really enjoyable. Obviously, Dominic Fike is not the greatest singer. Like, he doesn't have the craziest vocal range or anything, but he has a really good ear when it comes to melodies, you know. He really knows how to write melodies or how to just create melodies that are fun, that feel pleasant. So yeah, really enjoying this so far. You can really tell that these are B-sides, like, just without even it saying it's in the title, you know. It's a very rough mix, obviously, and it's still fucking enjoyable, so that's saying something. Yeah, I mean, obviously, you hear in the background just making fun of it a bit, and, you know, messing around with his vocals and everything. So yeah, this is what I mean. It's pretty cool to see artists experiment, and these experiments pan out into B-sides to an album. Okay, so that was the first B-side. Now we're gonna get into the second one. Okay, I just love how he uses guitars in his songs. It just sounds so pleasant, and it's just an interesting change of pace, you know, when you consider all the other music that's out there right now. And I don't know, what would you even categorize this as? Because it's not hip-hop, it has similarities with hip-hop. He has some songs that I would consider hip-hop, but I don't know, this is indie, maybe? It's like pop rock, indie rock, something like that. Take a break. Ooh. I fucking love that. The guitar riff in the background is fucking slamming, man. This shit's going good. I really want to see Dominic Fike on The Cave. If you don't know what The Cave is, it's a YouTube format by the producer Kenny Beats. It's pretty dope, you know. I fucking love watching The Cave. It's, depending on the artist, it can be fucking hilarious or really insightful, or there's just gonna be some really cool music coming out of there. And Dominic Fike, I think they're actually friends, so it would be kind of cool to see Dominic Fike on The Cave and just see what they would produce in an episode. My dumbass self obviously didn't explain what they fucking do on The Cave. They pretty much get into the studio together, and then the artist tells Kenny Beats what kind of beat he wants to have, and Kenny Beats just makes a quick beat, and I don't know, usually it doesn't take long, just some people are kind of, they really want their the beat to be a certain way, but after he did the beat for them, they get into the booth and just rap something. It was pretty much just a studio session broken down into pieces with more comedy in it, basically, and, you know. It's a cool insight into how songs are created. Oh, those harmonies are beautiful. I would have loved to see that go into a full song, you know. That's the last one sounded really good. Like I would really love to see that fleshed out into a real song, but so it's pretty cool. Oh shit, it says album coming soon. Holy, nice. That's pretty cool. I'm pretty excited about the album coming. I wasn't really thinking that he would release something, but sooner the better. I don't think it will be, you know, usually, if you're new to my channel, usually I rate these songs, but I don't feel like it would be justified to rate this since it's just B-sides. But I can tell you, I still really enjoyed these B-sides. You know, if they were fully fleshed out and fully mixed and mastered, they would sound really sick, especially the second one. That's pretty much it. If you have any other suggestions, you can leave them in the comments down below. And subscribe and like and, you know, all that shit. All that good shit. And see you guys next time.